Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here. How are you? We are in the process of getting the final pieces in place. We have our candy cane up top, as we like to call it. That's just really a weather head, a way to keep the water from being able to go up if it's raining. So you come up out of the ceiling, out of the roof, and then you make a 180 degree turn back down. So that helps to keep water from entering the building through our access pipe. Anyway, we ran a 3-inch PVC pipe through the building, and then coming down through the roof, we'll be able to run our wires. We have 3 wires coming down from each turbine. One of them is for the 3-phase power. The other one is for the servo, the stepper motor control. And then the final one is an 8-wire. It's actually a Cat6 Ethernet cable that we're using to send all the signals for the torque and the wind speed and stuff like that. So just signal wires, really. They're all 3 going to come down for each turbine. So we'll be running the first 2 turbines cabling through that. We did that this morning and it was a really nice day. We were actually pretty hot up there on the roof. So there will be more coming on that as we start pulling the wires through and then mounting the turbines up on the roof. You know, we're doing everything we can to keep this safe, to keep it easy. The whole point of the Ethernet wires is so that if a cable goes bad or gets cut or something, we can just unplug the Ethernet wire, pull a new wire through, plug it in, we're good to go. The power cords that we're using, believe it or not, are 16 gauge extension cord wires, because inside of an extension cord you have 3 16 gauge wires in there. So we're using that to transfer the wild 3-phase power down to the bottom. Don't worry, we're not going to be, you know, hooking it into anything, you know, with the dead man's cord or widowmaker cord, whatever they call them. So, you know, basically we're just using simple, easily accessible components to get our power, to get our readings, to get our sensor data and everything down to the ground, down to our SQL database that'll be on the ground at the ground level in our shop inside and protected from the weather. So the turbines will be out here, but no electronics should really be outside. It's just connections. Everything will be sealed up and then we'll be taking it down inside. We'll show you that process as we're doing it and as it unfolds. Today, we put the candy cane on the roof, and it's, you know, momentous because it's Christmas coming up, so we'll have to paint it with red and white stripes. Anyway, all right, guys, just wanted to fill you in. Thank you for being here with us, for staying with us on this crazy journey. We're having a lot of fun with it. We hope you are as well. We're sharing every single step of the process, and the really super exciting part once we get the turbines on the roof is we can finally start getting real-time data all day long. Whatever the weather does, whatever the wind is doing, we'll be able to gather it in real time. So, you know, we'll initially be gathering quite a bit of data, but then we'll probably tail off and start doing just averages and things like that once we kind of lock in on the right gear ratio and the right generator. So this is all so that we can very quickly and easily change out the generator to a different type or to a different gear ratio. We could just swap components easily. That's what the whole point of this is on the roof, to make it easy for us to go forward and do that. So thank you, our investors. Thank you to our Patreon subscribers. Thank you for being here with us on this journey and for following along. we're here because of you and we're here for you. So we'll keep sharing that journey as we go. Take care. Until next time, guys. Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.